Mama Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed, now are you? Check this out. You know, we've been talking about that last few days because our boy, the best fighter in the world, Terrence Crawford, right? He beats Kell Brook, number one pound for pound, there's no doubt about it. You know, but next fights, who is he going to fight? And, you know, we're talking about him and Spence. We talked about it. You know, they're having problems with a 60-40 split and things like that. And, you know, you just have to weigh in on stuff like that when it comes to Terrence Crawford, right? Because the bottom line is this. You know, you hear what happened to him and his promoter. And his promoter saying he's losing money on him, Bob Arum, right? Which I come did a video and told you he probably is. With the grand scheme of things, he's probably losing money on the guy, you know, because boxing is BTBG anyway. So when I told you there's not too many people, especially not of color, who's going to beat Terrence Crawford. So that's, you know, hence Spence. That's what that's all about, right? But let's make sure this is clear. And I know this is going to be, you know, probably, you know, people are not going to want to hear this right here, but this is what this is. This here is Pacquiao's fault. Manny Pacquiao's fault, right? That's why Terrence Crawford's not where he should be. That's why people are talking about it. Everything's Bob Arum's fault. Terrence Crawford came out the other day and said, well, Bob Arum has a good heart. And people that don't know either one of them that close are saying that he probably shouldn't say that. But we don't know any other things, you know, that went on. Maybe Bob Arum gave him an advance, right, when he needed to pay some bills, and Bob Arum didn't have the money. But he still tried to figure out how to pay Terrence Crawford an advance or something. You never know. Terrence Crawford knows those things. So I think it's for us, it behooves us to kind of chill out on when if he says something like that, the guy's not brainwashed or anything. It's the guy who's been paying him of late. And we're ignoring the fact that promoters cannot get in the ring for fighters. And we keep ignoring that. Manny Pacquiao is the problem here. But we keep ignoring that, like we all do. And then Americans especially, we just, it's got a slave mentality. We keep letting people off the hook. Manny Pacquiao is the problem here. And I will explain. And here it is. If Terrence Crawford fights Manny Pacquiao 2 years ago, 3 years ago, he's a mega star already, right? He would have beat him. And he's a mega star already. That's what I say about Negro League fighters. We don't give them the opportunity. I believe that Bob Arum tried to make that fight. And that's the biggest fight for Terrence Crawford. It would have been the passing of the torch, right? We were talking about it years ago. But Pacquiao ain't fighting him. Okay? That's the issue. One of the baddest guys fighting right now, Hall of Famer, the one they was calling the best, he's not fighting Terrence Crawford. And Bob Arum can't do nothing about that. Right? And that's the other ones. That's why people don't... Demetrius Andrade needs an opponent right now because his opponent got COVID, right? Canelo is not fighting him. If Canelo would have fought Demetrius Andrade 3-4 years ago or 2 years ago or last year or whenever, when it was an undisputed fight, he probably would have beat Canelo. He'd be a megastar. But we're not giving him the opportunity. And listen, folks, remember one damn thing. No demand, no fight. Okay? And there's not a demand for these guys that they can herald as being the very best to fight someone who they know is, and he's of color. We're not giving him the opportunity. We ain't got no time to have no another Floyd Mayweather up here making all the calls and making all the damn decisions and being the biggest guy in boxing. We're not having that. We didn't like that phase, right? So we're not having that. The same reason why, that's why Trump is in office. Because we're not having no 8 years of no other brother in the White House. It is called the White House. Ain't no barbecues and basketball courts supposed to be over there. Okay? Bottom line. So let's just stop, cut through the chase. Pacquiao ain't fighting Terrence Crawford. Canelo ain't fighting him. Canelo's throwing away millions of money. He's arguing with the Zone, arguing with Golden Boy, everybody. Because I ain't fighting Demetrius Andrade, and I ain't fighting Charlo neither. Okay, that's what happened. What happened to Rigondeaux? Bob Arum, able to say after Rigondeaux beats Nonito Donaire that he's boring. A small little dude beats a big dude who's number 3 pound for pound, and how he did it was boring. And it wasn't even close. Anybody go watch that fight when Guillermo Rigondeaux beats Nonito Donaire. It wasn't boring. So that's what's going on. And listen, when you're talking to Terrence Crawford and Spence, like I said before, he's bring undisputed to the table. And he brings number 1 pound for pound to the table. And I know people try to act like that's nothing. But let me tell you something. Undisputed and pound for pound number one are the biggest two things you can do in the sport of boxing. That's what kids dream about. Now, because we had Mayweather recently, now we're starting to talk a little bit more about pay-per-view and the pay-per-view numbers and all that old stuff, right? Which is important because it's your money and securing your future. No doubt about it. But when you're talking about boxing, Terrence Crawford has achieved everything that kids dream of when they start boxing. I want to be the very best at the game. I got check. I want to be the one champion in my division. Check. Those are the things we don't see. And I'm talking about a pound for pound number one when we know the world of boxing is very reluctant to put a brother up there. We know that. And he's still up there. Right? He's still up there at number one pound for pound. And I've been undisputed before. And I'm trying to be undisputed in my third weight class. Up higher when I'm fighting only bigger guys. And we're talking about to this guy like he isn't boxing royalty. It's ridiculous. This is Pacquiao's fault. Remember, Pacquiao fights Terrence Crawford. He's a megastar. Canelo fights Demetrius Andrade a few years ago. He's a megastar. Anthony Joshua fights Lewis the Real King Kong Ortiz when he should, supposed to, had to when he was the mandatory. Then he's a bigger star. Not saying mega, but a bigger star. We are not letting them. And right now, speaking of which, even Golovkin, about to fight Samaretta. DAZN is telling him too, just like they told Canelo, man, we got to renegotiate this contract. If you hell-bent on Samaretta's, we got a problem with that because we can't sell. We're not getting subscribers from you fighting Samaretta's and hell-bent on it and forcing Samaretta to become a mandatory when he's not a mandatory. That is the issue. We have to get these fighters that are not of color to fight hard fights. And the boxing world doesn't want to do that because the boxing world is a mirror of the world we really got out here. So let's bottom line, let's do that. Let's get up off Crawford and start focusing on, hey, Pacquiao, you could have fought him and he would have been big. Canelo, you could fight these guys. Canelo about to fight Callum Smith. Whatever, that's a whole nother video. Bottom line, and they're getting away with that. And then we get amongst ourselves and we're starting to talk about Terrence Crawford like it isn't boxing royalty. There's nothing more in the sport that this man can achieve that it doesn't have to do with financials. I am number one pound for pound and I have been undisputed. Who the hell else has? Think about that, guys. Doma Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all. Peace.